tired, I have a headache. So I weigh in. Pretty much the same, but I am going down. And I think the reason why I'm holding on weight too is because I'm supposed to be on my period. And I'm not sure if you guys followed me before, but I have endometriosis and I'm not supposed to have, I'm gonna have 3 months without a period. This is my second period not having, and I think I'm supposed to have my period this week. So yeah, so what? I get bloated, I get disgusting feeling, and that's what I feel like right now. But it is what it is. I'm going to make some coffee, edit or upload yesterday's video, and get ready for the day. Today's shoulder day, so let's get to it.
I am now going to the gym, have my Celsius I'm going to drink because I am tired. Still from having that coffee doesn't do anything for me anymore. Let me know in the comments below if it helps you, because it doesn't help me anymore. Then I got my 1 scoop of my Formula One with 1/2 scoop of my Ignition. And then got my Ghost BCAAs and Swedish Fish. And I'm gonna have 1/2 a bar of my Level One Chocolate Crunch. So that is my game plan. And I will show you guys something after the gym, because I called GNC and they have one thing that I'm looking for. They have 4 left. I'll go buy 3 of them. I'm gonna be nice and leave one for another customer. So stay tuned. But first, it is shoulder day, so let's crush it. Feels so good. I do feel a little sick though. Which is not good. But that's one thing about living in Georgia, that it gets cold hot. So, and I'm gonna have that now too. That's not helping. So I'm gonna have remaining of my bar and then my Ignition plus Formula One, and then head to GNC so I can show you guys what I am getting, and then I'm gonna go to Kroger and Walmart. So let's get this going and get home, eat, because I'm starting to get a little hungry. So let's do this thing. What I found, guys, I finally got my hands on Alani Nu Energy Cotton Candy Grape. This is gonna be what I'm gonna try tomorrow for my pre-workout drink. So, going to Kroger real quick, grab some frozen veggies, and then head to Walmart. Thing got me that flavor, and of course cotton candy. There's one more back there, but I'm so sure I can't reach it.
A girl that I follow on Instagram and on YouTube, her name is Lydia, I believe. She swears by this jerky, so I am going to give it a shot. They have it in Jamaican too, but I don't do spice, so this is what I'm going to try out and give you guys a review on this.
Into college square.
getting to Walmart, and I hate when you come to Walmart, you can only find the big carts, not the small carts. So now I have more reason to get more things than I intended to. I am gonna get some Epsom salt and the apricot salt that feel like the balls. So I'm gonna get that because the grandfather on YouTube said that having the episode and that works wonders. So I'm gonna try that, and maybe if I'm lucky, get a skate.
Picking up that. These last ones that you put in with those. And I got a little crazy and got me Sally Hansen pretty nail polish. Can't decide which one of these guys. I'll pick both. Grab this and then grab that. Found this too. I feel like this would be really good, but it's not zero. That's a lot of calories for this thing. So I'm actually gonna put this one back and get the diet version, because they have a diet version, but it's orange Coke instead, because this is a little bit too high for my liking right now.
This is zero. So I'm excited to try vanilla orange.
Been hearing some good things about that, so I'm gonna give it a try today.
And then got me some hauls because my throat is kind of warm.
Some of this, which is 5 bites, it's a pretty good bit. So this is really delicious. I usually put it on my yogurt, but usually eat it by itself. But this is going to be my lunch when it cools down. And I am actually making some sausages in here, and this is a sweet Italian. And this is what I showed you guys yesterday, and I have the apple one right here.
Actually works. It's a LA Colors nail polish removal in strawberry scented. It has 42 pads in it, so let's see if it actually works. If I can get it open. It really smells like strawberry. Yeah. Wow. Only 94 cents. Oh, that actually really works.
And that, you guys, that's what I'm working with right now. But of course, since I ate today, I of course gained, because that's how it works, because I started at this one, I was 148.4. So that's what I expected. So you eat, you gain a little bit. So not really, it's not a true gain, but you know what I mean. So I'm gonna start using this one, hopefully, and it will work for me. So see, this one right here was like $10 at Aldi's. This one right here, the Weight Watchers one, was I think like $25, so there you go. There's your difference.
Guys, I feel so relaxed and rejuvenated. Like, I feel so nice. I can probably go to bed right now. That's how amazing I feel. But I am not. I'm going to have me a snack because I'm pretty hungry. I'm going to have me some popcorn that I showed you guys yesterday. I'm not sure. I'll show you guys the flavor that I try or have. And then I'm going to try the orange vanilla drink.
Me 28 grams of the white cheddar cheese, skinny pop popcorn, and I got a serving, which is 28 grams, 1 ounce of that jerky that Lydia suggested, and I'll put her name right here so you can go follow her on IG and on YouTube. And it is time to try this baby out. Orange vanilla. Hopefully it tastes good, so I'll give you guys my honest review.
It smells like orange more than vanilla, so it might taste more orangey. So it might taste like a Fanta, maybe. It's actually crazy good. It actually tastes like orange vanilla. We taste more of the orange, but I actually kind of like it though. I can dig. I really like it. Now let's taste the original jerky. Oh. That goes fast. Want to try some? Let's see if a little boy likes it. You like it, Dee Dee? You like it? You like it? You do. He approves and I approve. So I'm gonna eat that, watch a recording, and then get to editing. So let's stop procrastinating and get stuff done. I do not know what's wrong with me, but I am like ravishing hungry. Like I am like so uncontrollably hungry. Eating two rice cakes right now. Had me some more of that popcorn that I showed you guys earlier. Had more of that, but I think it might have to do with not eating enough or just having a really, 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 really hard workout today. That could be awesome. I'm going to start eating before I go to the gym. That's what I did on Monday or Friday, Saturday. I forgot which day it was, but I actually ate for the gym. I actually felt pretty good. So I might start doing that again and see what that happens. But look at my nails. They look okay, don't they? I tried. I'm going to enjoy this. And watch or edit some more. Or edit. I haven't edited yet. So, this little boy wants some so bad. But he can't have chocolate rice cakes. I'm sorry, buddies.
So, I am actually going to eat. Ooh, I'm going to pop my bed. I am actually going to sit with you guys a little bit and chat with you guys about my TDEE, which is your total daily expenditure, and my macros and how I found the macros. So for a good 2 weeks, I logged my weight, and next to it, as you see right here, is where I put the date and how much carbs I ate for that day or the day before. Well, it says on February 7th, and technically ended February 21st. Did that, found my TDEE. Already knew it because I did my calculations on a website and through another formula, and that formula gave me about 2,000. But that's the one I got offline. And then the formula that I got was about 2,100. And basically what TDEE means, a totally daily expenditure, means that what you do on a daily basis without working out, just being alive. And basically I can stay the same weight, not gain, not lose, by eating 2,000 calories. To be honest with you, I was actually losing on 2,000 calories because if I go back onto my little note that I did, I started going down February 14th, and that's when I had pretty high carbs, and I got down to 145, and I basically stayed 145, 146, eating 2,000 calories, even more than 2,000 calories some days. I was still losing on, like I was saying, like I was still losing on 2,000 calories, but I was still kind of feeling kind of fluffy because I went to my NASCAR trip and I didn't really weigh anything. I just ate and I came back and I felt miserable. I came back and I weighed 154. Yeah, 154. We came back Monday, the 25th, weighed myself the 26th, and I was 154 even. So you can imagine how fluffy I felt and how disgusting I felt. And that's when I decided that I needed to get back on track. So basically I wanted to get back on track, tracking my macros again and just being more serious, because I really felt disgusting. And when I was intuitive eating, I actually felt pretty good. Like, I felt like I was leaning out. I felt less stressed, because I was less stressed because I wasn't counting macros. And it's okay to have a 2 week or a 2 week break from counting macros so you can get your mind focused in a way. And I might actually do that monthly, just to get my body a little break from counting. But since I'm doing this challenge of my own challenge I made, nobody else is doing it, but I wanted to prove to myself that it can happen and I can get my body that I wanted. So that's why I decided to count my macros again. I was counting my macros when I was doing intuitive eating, but I only was tracking my calories and my protein intake, and that was it. And now it comes to talking about what I did for figuring out my macros for all this, which is right here. Basically, I went back to my FitnessPal, looked at the days that I was smaller, which if you look on here, you see how I kind of outlined right there. And then I put in categories, carbs, protein, and fat. And then I broke the seven down and then divided it by seven. And it gave me, when I add all of it together and divided that by seven, and it gave me my average macros, which basically gave me a lot of fat, because when I looked, I didn't really notice that, but I've ate a lot of fat doing that intuitive eating. So my fat was pretty high, so it was like 97 fat, 93 protein, and 199 carbs. So I'm doing 200 carbs, about 110, 115 protein, but I've been going over that goal, which is good. I drastically dropped my fat from 97 to about 50 to 60, between 60 to 70, maybe even 50, 60. And yeah, that's my macros, and I eat about 1,700 calories. But today I'm lavishing, like I am so hungry, and I cannot deal with it. Like, I only have, right now my macros are sitting at 146 protein, 180 I think carbs, and about 70 fat. Hungry. So I think that I'm gonna start eating something, a little something in the morning before the gym, because I did that on, I want to say Monday. And I felt pretty good. I didn't feel as hungry. I showed you guys I had oatmeal, but this time I think I'm going to do steel cut oats instead and see how that works out. But yeah, it was tough figuring that out and stuff like that. But I felt really good doing intuitive eating for a little bit, a little break. And that's why it's all about balance. It's about finding what you feel is good for you. Fitness is about balance. Health is about balance. It's really all what you can do. And if you can't find balance and don't know when to stop or anything like that, then you haven't found your purpose yet, in my opinion. I don't know, just balance is a huge, huge thing for me, and how big it's gonna play a role in my journey, because I've struggled. I have my ups, I have my downs, and I want to be stronger. I want to find my true balance. Like, I want to find, well, I won't have to count macros anymore. Where I can just be like, oh, this is 80 grams. Okay, that's great. It's 40 grams of carbs. Okay, that's awesome. And maybe into the vegan. So that's the goal and all that stuff. But I'm actually fixing to end the vlog. It is 8:45. I'll come back later tonight before I head to bed. Show you guys my step goal. But since I didn't walk today, my step goal is gonna be pretty low. So bear with me, guys. So I will chat with you guys here soon. Since I'm still hungry, I made me a blueberry cheesecake pudding. I mean, what do we call it? Mug cake. So I'm gonna enjoy this and actually end the vlog in a second when I show you guys my Fitbit and where I'm at today. Did 7,444 steps, 1,905 calories, 3.76 miles, 4 flights of stairs, 48 minutes activity. Let's do that. Not really, really active today, but 5 out of 14 hours today was active. But yeah, that is what my Fitbit says. You guys have a great night. On the team.